I've been trying to purge single-use, leaky, alkaline batteries for my life for many years. I've tried all different types of battery types, and I finally found one that I think fits most of my needs. For years, I've used nickel metal hydride batteries using this charger that's at least 20 years old. Still works great. The batteries have actually held up over the years very well, but new technology has come around that changes the battery game completely. And that is lithium-ion rechargeable batteries. And I've been quite impressed with this XTAR brand. Now, many of the lithium-ion rechargeable batteries have a USB-C plug that allows you to charge the batteries individually. While this is convenient for travelers or in many use cases, it diminishes the amount of energy that can be stored in the batteries as the charging plug circuitry takes up a lot of space. So XTAR makes this set of 4150 milliwatt hour batteries, and it's a strange measurement as most other batteries are rated in milliamp hours. We can convert milliwatt hours to milliamp hours by using the formula milliwatt hours divided by voltage equals milliamp hours. So 4150 divided by 1.5 equals 2,766 milliamp hours. So these batteries store quite a bit more energy than even these Eneloops do. Eneloops are around 2,000 for this version, and the newer version might be all the way up to 2,400. So these are storing more energy and can be charged more times than nickel metal hydride batteries, and they should have much lower self-discharge. Where an Eneloop battery, which is a low self-discharge nickel metal hydride battery, it'll lose about 30% of its charge in a year. So one of the things I wanted to also do is get rid of this old charger, because again, it will only charge nickel metal hydride batteries. So XTAR also makes a charger that'll charge nickel metal hydride, 1.5 volt lithium ion, 3.7 volt lithium ion, and lithium ion phosphorus batteries. Or LiFePO batteries. And this size here will also take larger sizes of batteries as well, so it gives you lots of options on what you're able to charge. These chargers are also USB-C powered, so it makes it much easier to charge them, even on the go. So we just take a look at this charger. I'm gonna power it up with my USB-C battery bank. I have this tester that'll give us kind of the readouts of how much power it is using. So if I drop in a 1.5 volt lithium ion, it'll start detecting what it is, and then it'll start charging it as a lithium ion 1.5 volt. I can also take this 10440, which is a 3.7 volt lithium ion battery. Now this does have the USB-C charger in it, but it can also be charged in here. And then you can see it's detected as a lithium ion 3.6 volt battery. I can take this power owl nickel metal hydride battery, and it will also charge it. So this charger gives you lots of options on what you can charge. It also has other features as a grading feature where it will charge the battery to full and then drain it to get actually how much power the battery can still store. So we can see here, charging all of these, it's using half an amp at 2.5 watts to start charging these batteries. And again, the charge time is going to take based on the size of the battery and how much power you choose to put into it. Now you can choose different milliamps to put into each of the batteries. So you can go up to 500 milliamp, 250, so you can choose how fast it'll charge the batteries. I usually try to charge my batteries at the lowest I can to help, because again, heat is the number one killer of batteries. So the less energy you try to put into the battery in charging it, the longer it typically will last. So in testing these batteries, I've had great success in every device that I've tried. Looking at the the batteries. If we look at the size, one of the important things about replacement batteries is that they actually are close to the original size of what a AA or AAA would be. Some batteries are a little bit bigger and won't fit in devices, but you can see this is 4.2 millimeters wide. And if I just look at a standard Duracell, it's 4.1 millimeters. So it's pretty close in size. If we look at the length, again, it's going to be about 50 millimeters, 50.2. And if we look at this, we're also then looking at 50.3. So it's pretty close. I haven't found any devices where it won't fit into, but where I find that these are best are in high drain devices like Xbox controllers, radios, remote controlled cars. That's where these tend to have the best performance, again, because of the amount of energy that they can actually store in the batteries. You should be able to charge these at least 1,000 times before they have degradation. So you will be saving the environment by using these as well. I like to use these adapters that allow me to use a AA battery and convert it into, this one will convert it into a C battery. So compared to a C, you can see that then you can then use this inside of a device that uses a C battery. Now you're going to get less usage probably because a C battery should be able to hold more power than this. And that's why when you go to the adapters that will work as a D battery, they actually allow you to put in two batteries in parallel. And so this will give you a replacement of a D battery and will allow you to use that in your devices. And you should get similar run times again, because two AA's in parallel again will have that longer run time that a D battery typically would have. So I will leave links in the description if you want to take a look at these batteries, the XTAR VX4 charger. And I also put in links for the C and D battery converters if you're interested in those. Thanks for watching. You can watch my full comparison of nickel metal hydride, lithium ion, single use lithium batteries in the video here.